Well, welcome back once again. I'm getting back into this campaign, even if not many people are watching it anymore. Yeah, after my little break, I'm quite enjoying it again. Give you a very quick recap before we move on. So, we still hold all this land somehow. Basically, what these two armies down here did, hang on, these two guys, they took the settlements, but sacked them, so didn't try to hold them. And in response, I have my two full stack armies here coming out to meet them. These two are new. One of them is just raising Gallic troops cheaply, and it's a walled settlement, so I should be able to hold that even if they attack. The second one is just a general, and I created them because the game issued me a mission to give me some very small amount of free money and an extra little recruitment bonus if I recruited an army there, so I just recruited a general. So I'm thinking I might take him and move him down to this settlement here just to help improve their happiness because they're still not very cheerful. We repelled a very, very large attack here, which has weakened the, who are they, bitter, I hate these names. Biturigish. It's weakened them immensely. So they've gone from, I think, four full stack armies down to one and a half now. And I didn't take any damage in return. So that's, if you look here, this whole center west area sort of opened up. And I've moved Caesar up. There he is. Next to Vienna. Make sure we hold that province, which was going to rebel. Slightly worried by these guys, the Vacontii. Let's have a look. The Vacontii, I was going to attack them before and decided I couldn't afford to do it. And they're now moving armies south. Is that going to attack this settlement? And what are these guys doing? So that's a bit of a concern. Also, the Aedui seem to be moving armies south. Well, they're holding. These guys have moved into my territory, which again is rather worrying. So, moved my full stack army from this walled settlement here down to Vienna here. So they're now holding that and stopping them rebelling. I've raised a new army here. And I'm raising Gallic troops just to make sure I can hold that. I have spotted one army coming down, but that's the Suebi. And I don't need to worry about those guys just yet, not until they come down here and are obviously going to threaten. So the east is kind of okay, just need to watch these guys. I've got these two full stack armies moving west to counter these two full stack armies of the enemy. This province has been entirely fucked over, just utterly, utterly fucked. Lots of sacking going on, so my income's dropped a lot. My food's still okay, but I need to retake this, destroy their armies, so that I have some income. We have more armies coming down from the north. So we're under assault, and we're just about holding it, basically. This is okay now. So I'm going to keep those guys there and just make sure this is safe. That's absolutely critical that I hold that. So it gives me freedom of movement in the west here and possibly if the Aedui attack in the center. Or if these guys attack, I'll have to rush these two armies back down and take them too. So, there you have it. Let's see what happens. Oops. Out of skill. Always out of skill. There we go for authority. Authority! Let's see what happens now. Oh, that's not good. Look at the Aedui. Obviously going to attack. With. You're attacking again. You just sacked this settlement. The point of that. So these armies come down and have nothing else to do. Same here. Ridiculous. I've got two full stacks there. And one. Oh, it looks like they're holding this time. So they've actually taken almost the entire province. The Contii, these are the guys in the sort of south in the middle. So they didn't attack. Faction joins your enemies. Okay, I don't know where they are. Sabotage. Here, more sabotage, more sabotage, more sabotage. Right. Alliance forged. Let's see what's happened. This is all lots of agents doing me damage. God, look at that. That's not good. It's just not good. If I get attacked, I mean, if they attack Vienna, I have utterly no chance whatsoever. Okay, so they've pulled that full stack back here, which is good. But then, what is this? What is going on here? Is that there to protect me, or what? I really don't know. So this is the general I recruited just because I get a bonus for doing so. I'm going to move them over to hold that province, that settlement. Let's check on the north. This is now fine, so I don't need to worry about that. I'm very concerned about this. And I'm tempted to move these armies out. Because if they attack Vienna, if that's what's going to happen, I've got five full stack armies. There's no way I can win. There's no way I can win. I've got heavy units as well. I mean, yeah, I can't win. So the smart thing would be to move back to a walled city. What I can do, at least, is take the initiative here soon. I'll be able to destroy these guys shortly. So let's get... They had their orders intercepted, which means they can't march as far. These guys can't get very far either, so I'm going to just make sure they're at least close enough to this other army to not get too damaged. It's close enough. Hopefully they'll reinforce each other if they get... Yeah, they will. That's what the yellow line means. Hopefully they're far enough away to not get attacked as well. I need to add some troops to these guys. At least we're holding here in the west. We have more full stack armies coming down the western coast, and it looks like they're just going to avoid this wall settlement and come down where it's easy to get through. I'll come back to that in just a second. I'm going to make sure that these guys at least have enough to repel an attack if I have to abandon them. Come, fight for Rome. Which is very possible. By abandon them, I mean they may have to defend by themselves against one or two of these full stack armies if they do attack. Need to make a decision here. I have to make sure these are safe, no matter what. the Aedui extremely angry with me.
Greetings. Now speak.
But we do have a military access agreement. Honest folk. So they are technically they're not. I know I can't trust them. We can move my armies out. It may give them a tempting target, but a defense would be completely pointless, so I feel like I don't have an alternative at this moment in time. I'm just going to have to abandon Vienna to its fate. The way is blocked. And then build more troops here to make sure that, well, my attack or defense or whatever I do next is as effective as it can be. Soldiering, it's a good life. Great thing about Gallic troops is they are so cheap. They are so cheap. So I'm just going to build as many as I can. And there's really not much else I can do. I do not have the initiative in this game anymore. I just need to do the best I can, really. Ah, they've declared war. There we go. See the Aedui just turned red? If it comes around to their turn. So their turn has passed, it seems. They didn't go for Vienna. Bankrupt. Oh, shit. Oh, that's a real problem. Need to take some settlements back. Immediately. Oh, God. Right, I need to capture this settlement and then I'll get some money. It's far too far away. Why bother giving me that? Bloody hell. Oh, this isn't easy. I'm going to have to take a settlement back. Even that may not be enough. I have to throw in my lot. So I was right, at least, to move Caesar out. I don't know what I'm going to do in response to this lot. So if they take Vienna, that's going to reduce my income even more. Not good, guys. To your duties, men. Really, this is one of the. This is not good. Ready for orders. We hunger for battle. Let's have them attack. None, Willis. Our path is blocked. Attack. Let's lay siege. We take this settlement for Rome. Reinforce with these guys. We have to win this. We have to take the West back. We have to get our economy back on track. And then the current threat has changed, maybe? From the West to the center. Now the Aedui have become the main threat. Oh, man. And we have more coming down on the West. This is ridiculous. I've never played a campaign this difficult. Never. Don't even know what to do. As you command. If you don't have the initiative, you're pretty stuck, really. Can't use my spy because I don't have any money. Let's just see what this looks like. At least this is a battle I can win.
Besieging settlement.
Let's just make a couple of decisions and then come back to that. These guys, we have this army. they're going to have to come up towards this direction.
Advance.
We have two full stacks in the west. We should be able to retake that entire area.
Is that all?
And then we have 1, 2, 3, 4 in total here to deal with the Ardui. They'll retake Vienna. But if I can get these 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, if I can get these guys to join up. With Caesar in the lead. And these are very strong armies as well. I think we can beat the Ardui. And yeah. Maybe begin to retake the initiative, as long as they don't have any more armies up here, which I doubt they do. Because there would be no reason to. These guys are rearming, creating new armies, but I think I'll be able to deal with them just as well as I did last time, as long as I keep that unit and stack there. So this south should be okay. Middle's looking okay. Vienna's going to go. But then, actually, it was a benefit not to attack the Fecontii, because then the Ardui will stop and head towards one of the walled settlements. And I can attack them with three full stacked armies. So, let's take the west back. Continue with our game. Right, you bastards. Let's utterly, utterly destroy you. I'm going to throw my Gallic troops in the front lines. If I lose them, it doesn't matter. Another good thing is I'm taking a settlement here, so the enemy will head to the capture point, the victory point, which makes it easier to kill them. They will stand there and take plenty of fire from my armies. Let's just see. I still have the timer on. That's just because I forgot to turn it off. This isn't a wall settlement, so I don't need to worry about that. Spear warriors in the front. Celtic warriors second line.
Warriors!
Heavy legionaries third. Legate. Wait for my reinforcements. Let's get them on the field. Now they have reinforcements coming in as well. I just need to make sure that they don't come in a terrible place and sort of ambush me somehow. It's looking like it's fine. Archers up in the third rank so they can fire over the top. Skirmishers up in the front. Heavy spearmen. I guess they'll form my triarii. And we have more heavy legionaries, so I'll have them form a proper fourth rank there.
Advance at speed.
Two units of legionaries. Guess I'll join them up with the heavies. Makes things nice and simple. And I'll keep my two generals together back. So again, I'll just speed that up. Cavalry? Ah, good. Do you have cavalry? Make sure there are no... Ah, there are their reinforcements here. There you go. So they're going to head to the capture point, which is good for me, because they sit in the middle. Let me take the initiative. It means I can use all of my ammos. All of my arrows. Ammos. Alright, let's start moving forward. It's gonna be. Can I go on this? Yeah, I can use this hill. No, I can't. I can't use that hill, there's only one way through, and that's the road. Which is where their reinforcements are going. Is there any other way to access this capture point? It looks like there isn't. So it's just this one road here. Let's go forward and capture this square. There may be units there. If there are, I'll stop. But nope, looks like it's empty. At least for the moment. And they're coming down though. Yep, and they're heading for the catch point, so that's perfect. I'm going to stop these guys. Stop. Have them form a shield wall. So they take slightly less damage. So my Celtic warriors go just behind. I need to get my archers up to counter this fire. Here you go, they're attacking. Good. This is good. Send my cavalry around this way. I'll be able to take out some of their skirmish. No, actually. Are there any more reinforcements? No. Send my cavalry up to the top of the hill so I can hit them from behind. Perhaps. When I take my Celtic warriors, I'm going to send them into the fray. So my spear warriors start taking some real damage. It's fine for the moment. So my archers are doing their work. I'm going to send one of these units up to deal with their slingers. Let's bleed them too. As long as they can get within range. Starting to hit their slingers. They are still firing my spear warriors, which is fine.
Ready and waiting. Orders. By your command, commander. By your command. Advance at speed.
Right, it'll be time to send in my shit, I'm getting hurt. I'm gonna fire on them.
Move it! Get sorted! Break off!
Alright, that strategy is not working, so I'm going to move them back. Time for the warriors. Send them in a frenzy. I'm going to watch this. Celts on Celts. Celts on Celts action. Very colourful. Very colourful. Especially my side. Because they have the better armour, I suppose. Let's make sure the archers are firing in the right place. We hit the Old Sworn, the heaviest unit, toughest unit. Where are they? There we are, 103 of them. Definitely need hitting them in. Just bring the cavalry round. No other threats. Just remember to bring my generals up. No threats from behind. Good. These spear warriors are actually doing very well. This unit of cavalry, they're going to hit the slingers, or at least stop them firing on me. Of course, the enemy will attack to defend their slingers, so I'll pull my cav out just as soon as they start to threaten them. Which is now. That's just to stop them firing as much as anything else. Okay, nearly destroyed the unit, which is good. These guys are nearly all broken. We'll pull that unit of cav out. Just get them back to safety. Come on, quick, 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 quick. And yeah.
Battle ready!
It's pretty much their first wave broken. Let's get my cavalry back on the hill. Oh wow, I'm impressed. So the units that were right in the middle of the battle line, the very front lines, did very well. Let's go for their youths, which are skirmisher units. They should fire pretty soon as soon as the arrows begin. Here we go. It's 80, 75. Sixties, yeah, there we go. 45, 48, there we go. Stop them firing on me. Gallic warriors are coming in, but we still have our shield walls. These Gallic troops are quite good. I'm surprised. Didn't really recruit any in the early game, because didn't have much confidence in them. Not bad. Stop the archers for the moment. I'm going to save that ammo. Send my warriors back in and the cav to hit them from behind. It's all looking good so far. Should be a pretty good battle. Haven't even engaged the legionaries yet. I think I might try to save these units. There's no point spending money on recruiting the same units again if I don't have to. It's far better just to keep your armies out of trouble for a turn or two.
Skirmishers!
Stop firing.
Melee cavalry. Orders understood. Gelds!
Take them out. Wavering. Try to walk along. Should break any second. Break. Shattered, so they don't rejoin. My spear warriors are at the point where I don't really want to use them anymore. So it's time to bring up the tougher troops. Late Roman Imperial spear. There we go, they're shattered. Bring my Celtic warriors back. Cavalry back up to their position. There we go. And now I can get ready for the these guys just out of the way. And get ready for the assault of the skirmishers.
We hunger for blood and battle.
Do a spear ward just for the in response to this charge. Let me see. I'm going to overwhelm them with a frenzy. Should destroy their unit really, really quickly. Stop my spearmen so they don't get involved in that fight. There's no point them taking damage unless they have to. Now it's looking pretty good because I can destroy most of these guys with my archers without taking too much damage myself. These guys are all skirmishers. So if I... they have a cavalry unit. I was going to say I would attack them with my cavalry, but the timing is not very good. These guys are taking too long to break. Alright. So the next round, it's going to be late Imperial spearmen in the front rank. Celtic warriors in the Celtic warriors in the front rank, because I don't care about those so much. Late Imperial spearmen in second rank, and then all my legionaries in third. And then I'm just gonna hold. Here we go. Cav out. Looks like they're attacking me, which is alright. I'm gonna start my archers firing again. Maybe I don't need to attack them too much. Maybe they'll do the do my work for me.
Skirmishers, our spears are yours. We will pierce.
Get my Celtic skirmishers up as well. Turn on auto fire for them. This is just brilliant. They're
warriors,
making it easy. Come on, attack.
Warriors! Kill, kill, kill!
Cavalry again to their rear. This means they shouldn't last too long at all. It's too easy. Still my units firing on my own men.
Skirmishers.
Kind of see an opportunity to put my archers here, actually.
Archers.
This could be kind of good.
See
if that works.
Warriors, move out. Battle ready.
Destroy their spearmen and Freeman.
Engage!
And bring up these late Imperial spearmen just to form a kind of wall. To make sure they don't take on my skirmishers. I love how they call them scrappers. Did you hear that? It said scrappers ready. Which is pretty accurate. They're going after my cavalry, I'll just move them back up to the hill and range. Start the assault.
Skirmishers!
Fire. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Oh, just destroying them. Here we go, it's frenzy. And again, I need my cavalry to come and hit them in the rear. Same strategies. They work beautifully. So that was good. These archers firing on these troops. Is there any point? I suppose there is. May destroy their units completely rather than letting them survive a little.
Skirmishers!
Stop the skirmishers firing. Right. So we're doing extremely well here.
Infantry.
Time for final. So again, Celtic warriors first. I may bring my spear warriors back into play. Keep my best units at the end. Stop these guys firing. Bring my legionaries up now. And assault them on two sides, I reckon. Cavalry ready. This unit, have them retreat. They're damaged. They just, there's no need for them to play any part in this battle anymore. Here we come. Ah, I'm shooting walls. Messy up there. My archer's involved. Can he reach? Yeah. Let's just get them using all their ammo. Yeah, I think there's an opportunity for my cavalry here. No. Is their cavalry up charging? That's not a good idea. Let's just keep them. Let's put them on this side. So they can attack their skirmishers. Come on, let's get legionaries involved. Time for the big boys. I don't want to deal with their cavalry until my legionaries are there. I'm going to hit them in force with everything. Here we go, the big boys. Let's watch this. That. So I'm going to hit their cavalry first. Look at this. Heavy legionaries at that. With the whip. Toughest melee units in the world. Where's my
legionary cavalry?
Got cavalry involved in the skirmishes. Take the Celtic warriors and have them frenzy on attack into the skirmishes through the swordsmen. An annihilation. These legionaries up properly. So they're wavering, cavalry here, even though they still have most of their unit. Just giving up. These warriors out of trouble's way. Let's get my cavalry after those guys. Where are you? It's Legatus. It's Legatus. Here we are. Let's get them to just destroy the skirmishers so they don't, can't play in the next battle. Charge them down. Right, then we have these Celtic warriors. We don't need to be here. Let's get them. Yeah, there we go. Done. Went very well. Destroyed all of them. I don't think we lost a single unit either. It's about as good as it gets. There we go. Let's see if this helps our income, because that's just so worrying. Well, they had one unit survive. That's bollocks. Occupy.
Ready for battle.
Oh, it's done nothing for our income. It's terrible. Ooh. Don't even know who they were.
Ready for
oh god. This income thing is a real real bugger.
Ready for battle.
Too far away to attack these guys. I can't move these.
We hunger for battle.
I'd attack that army if I could, but
ready for battle.
I just can't. Tolosa has enough. They'd have enough to defend against that army, I think.
Ready for orders.
So I'm going to put these guys close to the second army just so they can reinforce each other and actually slightly north. Perhaps we could take both of these towns back? I don't know. We need to keep those together so they reinforce each other anyway. Hey! And again, we see what happens next. This is... I can't disband units at this stage.
We hunger for battle.
I suppose I can disband giant ballista. They're not very useful.
At your command.
Yeah, I'm gonna do that.
Commander.
See if that makes a difference.
Commander.
Only giant ballista. So they only deploy when you're attacking.
Ready for orders.
And at the moment, I'm not attacking very much.
We hunger for battle.
No. That's wrong. They only deploy when you are not reinforcing.
Ready.
That's it. So, I got rid of all of those. I'm nearly there. I have to get my books to balance. it's a nightmare. Absolute nightmare.
Ready for orders. We hunger for battle.
They're all essential. This unit cannot be replenished because you are bankrupt. You see? That's why it's important. These guys are pretty much done. So I guess I could get rid of those two. Anything else? Ah, this is painful. So painful. Right, let's get rid of cheap units that we don't cost a lot. So Roman units cost a lot. So I'm not going to disband those.
Ready for orders.
So that just leaves these guys.
We hunger for battle. At your command.
Yeah, let's just lose the ones that took the most damage. Nearly there. This is so painful. Okay. Surplus of 54 bucks. And at least they're replenishing. Hey! Right, I'll leave it there to see what happens. Keep an eye out for the next episode. Thanks for watching, guys. Ta-ta.